Dear students, welcome to our class on irrigation scheduling based on evapotranspiration advances 1. Okay, before we go into the class, a small quote only to inspire you. The greatest challenge in life is discovering who you are. Discovering who you are. And also the next challenge is making yourself by yourself. Okay, so let's go straight to scheduling. What is meant by irrigation scheduling? Irrigation scheduling involves deciding when and how much water to apply to a field. The goal of an effective scheduling program is to supply the water with sufficient water under or overwatering can lead to reduced yield. Under means deficit, over means extra. So good scheduling of water at right time and at the right quantity optimize the yields of the irrigation scheduling benefits. What are the benefits of irrigation scheduling? So since we have water, we cannot go on giving the water. So we should schedule what are the advantages of it? What is the benefit of irrigation scheduling? Improved production. What farmers really wanted is more production, more money, higher quantity and higher quality yield. Of course, lower grain pH, greater color intensity, not only in agriculture but also in horticultural plantation. In case of horticultural plantations, lower fruit pH. Okay, here load grain pH. Why? To insert crop. No. So controls vegetative growth, water conservation, reduced nutrient leaching is another benefit. Go straight to what is the criteria for irrigation schedule? Soil moisture regime approach, climatological approach, and plant indices approach. Now, so we discuss, ours is agrometeorology, we go straight to climatological approach. What are the climatological approaches? Evapotranspiration is the first climatological approach for scheduling of irrigation. Now, what is it? The amount of water lost by evapotranspiration is estimated from climatological data, and when ET reaches a particular level, then irrigation is scheduled. So this is what different methods are there for scheduling the irrigation of them. Number one is irrigation water by cumulative fan evaporation ratio, IW by CPE, irrigation water by cumulative fan evaporation ratio. It's very interesting. It's very dependable. Very, very interesting. How and why? A known amount of irrigation water is applied when cumulative fan evaporation reaches a predetermined level. Say, for example, for most of the times we give 5 centimeters of irrigation, generally 0.75 to 0.8 IW by CP ratio, we use the irrigation for the tropical regions, whether it's oil seeds, pulses, or seeds. Now, potential evapotranspiration, several times I told, we discussed, I did not discuss here again. Just for your academic interest, more often heat information is gathered by using evaporimeters. Two types of evaporimeters are there. We offer evaporation fan, that is the USWB, United States Weather Bureau open fan evaporimeter. Of course, the next one is the atmometer. We have already discussed this applied here. This is the evaporation fan. This is the atmometer. Now, see, there for every crop, there is a moisture sensitive stage. Just for your academic interest, I go on saying it. In case of rice, panicle initiation flowering. In case of wheat, crown root initiation, jointing and milking. For sorghum, it is a seedling at flowering stage. Sorghum seedling stage and flowering stage. Maize silking and gathering. Bajra flowering panicle initiation. Of course, as far as groundnut is concerned, rapid flowering, pecking, early pod formation. Red gram flowering and pod formation. Green gram flowering and pod formation. Similar for background, sugarcane is a formative stage. Sesamum blooming stage to maturity. Sunflower 2 weeks before and after flowering. Safflower from rosette to flowering. Soybean blooming and seed formation. Cotton flowering and bulb formation. Okay. Tobacco transplanting to full bloom. In case of chilies, flowering. In case of potato, tuber initiation to tuber maturity. Onion bulb formation to maturity, tomato from the commencement of fruits that are the moisture sensitive. I say thank you formally. I just repeat the quote only to inspire you. What is it? The greatest challenge in life is discovering who you are. In addition to that, making yourself by yourself. Nobody makes you. You have to make yourself. Thanking you for your patient hearing. May God bless you.